Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. Man, I seem to be picking a lot of hard topics to talk about and on YouTube lately. But this is gonna be definitely the most challenging one for me, or the most difficult one to kind of just put my finger around. But yeah, this video, I'm gonna be just sharing my personal thoughts on the concept of marriage and kind of what that means to me, and why I'm so fucking terrified of it. So, I mean, marriage to me is that concept is such a huge concept. It's such a grand concept. It's not, when I think about that concept, I don't just think about two people falling in love and having a happily ever after. It's not as simple as that for me. And it's weird because I actually, like, I love that concept as well. And it's a happy ending to, like, so many, like, romantic comedies and chick flicks and stuff. And, you know, I am guilty of, you know, it's weird as a guy, but I am guilty of really enjoying chick flicks and romantic comedies, and I know like 80% of them end with like a marriage or a wedding scene, and it's so cliche now, but at the same time, it's still kind of like it's a good happy ending sometimes, and I like it sometimes, but like when I think about my life in that manner, and I don't know, I feel like. And I also watch a lot of, being Korean, I watch a lot of Korean dramas, and of course there's a lot of different marriage involved, although in Korean, I think I relate more on that concept where marriage is more than just about two people falling in love with each other and living happily ever after. It's also a very social, economic, and legal thing. The legal issue is not talked about in dramas or movies that much, but this whole social aspect of it, or the political aspect of it even, is brought up a lot, especially in Korean dramas. Like, one of the biggest trope in Korean drama is a rich guy falls in love with a poor girl, or a country bumpkin girl. And, you know, they love each other. But then, he's from a rich family, and she's from a poor family. Of course, the rich family is going to oppose the marriage. The poor family finds, like, really strong opposition from the rich family and get mistreated, and you see this happening. So in Korean dramas, it's portrayed, marriage is really portrayed as an acceptance or a total union, not just between two people who love each other, but also between their families as a whole, their parents, their extended families. So it's a social, like, acceptance thing. And that's personally what terrifies me the most. And it's also really based on economical thing too. People marry in their own class or people in their own religion, their own race. Marriage is usually a very like-minded people coming to, you know, with the like-minded people, which, you know, is just, that's just how it is. I mean, I personally think it's awesome when like two totally different people, you know, kind of upset the social balance. But even in this day and age, in 2013, something like that is still, like, ridiculously difficult. You know, that's why a lot of people don't go through with it, because it's just difficult. And, you know, even in this day and age, in 2013, a Korean drama, like, presents that. Like, and it's this same race, same religion. It's just that one guy is from a rich family and the girl is from a poor family. You know, and that creates such drama and such intense bickering and stuff. It's terrifying, and you know, whew, you know, that's like the terrifying aspect of marriage. But it's not even, marriage is not only about, like, class is not the only difference you can have in, like, a marriage, you know? I mean, race is another thing, religion is another thing, and I can imagine, like, a Jewish guy, like, Orthodox Jewish person falling in love with, I don't know, Pakistani Muslim girl. Imagine that happening. You know, I mean, two may love each other, but the whole family coming to accept that marriage is going to be quite a fight. And that's also one of the things I think about in this, when people say, we think about marriage nowadays, especially in politics, I mean, it's clearly obvious, like, where the conversation will lead to, which is just gay marriage. And it's so weird, because they're fighting for a legal right to have gay marriage. You know, it's illegal for gay people to be married. But if it's legal, their problems aren't over. Like I said, it's an acceptance of two families in most cases. That's going to be a bitter, bitter fight. Like a hard struggle. And that's why, like, it's so amazing when I'm browsing the news and I see, like, you know, New York passed gay marriage recently. And, you know, it's just like, hey, this is a news article of two 80-year-old couples, you know, people who are, these two people are 80 years old, and just this year, they finally were able to marry these two women. And so, like, I was like, that's amazing. Not only are, it's amazing that they were able to wait about 40 years of, you know, in a committed, long committed relationship, about 40 years to be able to marry. That's so amazing. And it's so amazing that they were able to marry, even though, I mean, it's legal to marry, but then there's also this, like I said, another obstacle, a social obstacle. Just because it's legal doesn't mean it's easy. You know, like when segregation finally became no longer the law of the land, I mean, that didn't automatically mean that a black student could just go into a school full of white students and just start receiving education. Yeah, it's legal, but good luck, because that's why you need all these police troopers protecting you when you go to classes. Legal things happen quicker than actual social acceptance. That's unfortunately the nature of things. So, I mean, when I think about even just gay marriage, it's just like, oh my gosh, it's illegal. Like, that's so stupid. But at the same time, even if it does become legal, the fight is not over for them. They have a long battle ahead of them, even after it being legal. And so, like, that's just something that, like, you know, I just think about. But for me, marriage is terrifying because my dad is kind of the traditional, like, oh my gosh. If I ever found a woman that I want to marry, it's going to be a Korean drama all itself. It's going to be like the most ridiculous thing ever. My dad opposing the marriage, and there's just being this bickering, and he would probably try his best to get me out of the marriage or to end the marriage somehow. And I don't think my parents would accept the marriage. There would be this whole kind of weird thingy going on there. I don't know, because see, my dad wants me to, first of all, he doesn't really have too much criteria. There are like two simple criteria: that I should marry a girl who doesn't wear glasses, because he wants his grandson or granddaughter to have good eyesight. Yeah, ridiculous. So that's one weird criteria. The second one is the girl should be Korean. And, you know, either Korean-American, it doesn't matter, but just Korean. Be able to communicate Korean, appreciate Korean culture, and know Korean culture, be of Korean culture. Yeah, fat chance of that happening, because I'm not really Korean people, me, not really happening there. So the two girlfriends that I've had in my life were black. So yeah, that's what's terrifying to me. But even just going aside from that whole issue of my dad ultimately opposing a marriage, marriage as a concept is kind of terrifying to me, because I have this view where I can't possibly see being me, like, committed to just one person. I always have this fear that, like, if I get involved with someone, I will end up, like, totally breaking their hearts, which I actually did with my ex-girlfriend, because I was the dumper and not the dumpy. So that's always that fear. Like, and then marriage is, you know, I know you can always divorce, but in the ceremony, you actually do say till death do you part, and you say I do to that. I don't think I could ever say I do to that. Like, I don't know if I'm gonna, you know, be willing to commit to you till death do I part. That's kind of a ridiculous, See, my thing is, I don't think human beings are necessarily monogamous creatures. And I don't think, like, this, when I read Brave New World and how people can just kind of be, you know, open about freely exchanging sex with different kinds of people and not being too attached, I think that's okay. Like, I don't have any problem with that. I mean, I do value this whole, I think the reason we value relationship is because we do have that, like, oh, you know, you like, aside from everyone else in the universe, you are more special to me than anyone. I mean, that's a really special thing. And that's why, like, this whole, like, cheating on someone when you're dating someone is such a morally wrong thing to do. And I agree, that's a morally wrong thing to do, because it hurts people, because it's not accepted that, you know, people should be freely exchanging their partners sexually or emotionally or relationship-wise. But to me, like, I'm of the view where if I'm dating someone and that person, like, we have a good relationship, and that person, I don't know, for some reason finds this other guy, like, more sexually attractive and occasionally have sex with him, whatever, and would still, like, I'm okay with that. Like, that's not a crazy concept that makes me upset, which is why, like, the whole idea of marriage is kind of just, huh, to me, you know? Like, it's special to have one person, like, be like, oh, you're the most special person to me ever. It's nice, but I don't really feel like it's people can do it. I think that's why divorce rate is so high, because now we come to a stage in our society where marriage is something that we do because we love that person, and so we're doing it for love. Whereas in the past, marriage wasn't really for love. Marriage was for economic stability, political stability, political power, for social reasons, social prestige. Usually marriages were arranged, and people were okay with that. People, because marriage wasn't for love, it was to have this family, and, you know, people sometimes were unhappy, but they just kept it because it, you know, for stability reasons. But now people are marrying for love, and that's a whole different thing, because I think for a lot of people, me included, like, staying in love with just one person for the rest of your life is hard. I don't know if I can do it. I don't know if half the population can do it. And I think that's why the divorce rate is so high. But that's really just my just thinking about marriage. I don't think I'll ever get married, me thinking this way, especially with my dad. I'm pretty sure that if I ever fall in love with someone, it's not going to be Korean. It's probably going to be, I don't know, but it's definitely, it's the chance of the girl I fall in love with being a Korean girl is very, very low, if that even happens, you know. So that's just my entire thoughts on marriage, just me babbling on about, man, this really was a hard topic to talk for me, just because I don't know why it was, but yeah, it was.